there's a tendency for, at least there's a perception of legal academics that we sort of work in silos. But at the end of the day, I think that's really not the case. Legal academics work in teams just like legal practitioners do. And so I've seen that in my own work, starting to develop with interdisciplinary collaboration. I don't have a PhD in economics or a PhD in sociology, yet I'm seeing how those disciplines have real relevance to my work in corporate law. And so to reach out, become part of a research team that has a sociologist, economist, a political science, et cetera, that really provides for an enriching dialogue, and it strengthens the quality of the work. I think that legal academics have a lot to say to practitioners, and often we seem to sort of work as sort of two solitudes, but I think that is starting to change. I had the good fortune to co-convene an expert consultation for the UN Special Representative on Business and Human Rights. And this was a wonderful consultation. In terms of geographic diversity, we had participants from Africa, Asia, South America, etc. And in terms of intellectual diversity, we had corporate lawyers, we had representative of corporate firms, we had human rights NGOs, members from the SRI community, etc. And to get these people together and have a set of different conversations on how law informs business and human rights was absolutely fantastic. It was clear that these are people who haven't talked to one another before. So I think academics can really help business people, business lawyers, to think about the broader social implications of their work. So one of the takeaways from the UN expert consultations that I mentioned was a set of guiding principles on how businesses can address human rights related issues and human rights risk. And that's been a key takeaway because many businesses have started to adopt this UN framework, and it's given them sort of practical on the ground guidance. And that guidance, I think, will be key going forward for corporations that operate transnationally. Yeah, so one of my current projects, I'm writing a book on the lack of gender and racial diversity in corporate governance positions globally. It's a book that will be published by Cambridge University Press, and how law can facilitate diversification. I'm a real fan of research in action or engaged scholarship. So for me, it's not just about keeping research in the ivory tower, it's about seeing law, legal research mobilize policy change. And it's really interesting to look at the different initiatives that are happening more broadly on corporate governance diversity. So the initiative that you've mentioned is fantastic. I think that the fact that we have legal leaders really getting together on this, thinking about this seriously, seeing the problem and mobilizing around this issue, I think at the end of the day, law can only do so much. Changes in corporate governance diversity have to come from the key players. Sure, law can incentivize those players, and that is very important, but at the end of the day, Legal Leaders for Diversity and other such initiatives play a key role.